Today we are going to start the revision of the chapter The Little Girl. Okay, so what the chapter The Little Girl is about? The chapter Little Girl is about a young girl, small girl named Kezia, who was very much afraid of her father. So what kind of relationship is shared between both of them? In the starting, it was a relationship full of fear, being afraid. And in the end, it has turned into a relationship of, you can say, understanding, love and understanding. And this is how it has happened in that chapter. But ultimately, what has brought this change in the thinking of Kezia? Okay, how she come to know that actually her father, he actually loves her? Because in the starting, what she was thinking? She was thinking that her father is not loving her. She was always thinking that her father is of very strict nature, okay, who doesn't care about her. And she's always thinking that she's comparing her father with that of Mr. McDonald. Okay, who is Mr. McDonald? Okay, who's always playing with his children. So this is the reason why she was feeling so. She is always feeling that there are different type of fathers in this world. So her father is of different nature and Mr. McDonald is of different type. So how this chapter starts? So Kezia, she used to get up in the morning. As she is staying at home, her father used to come to her room and kisses on her cheek. This is the love of the father, actually. Okay, he used to kiss her on her cheek, and but Kezia, she's always waiting that her father should immediately or should hurriedly go out of the house. And she was feeling relaxed, she was feeling relieved when she heard the carriage going away from the house. Okay, so what is the daily routine? Daily the father is going to office. And in the evening when he comes from office, so what is there? How he comes? First of all, he asks for a cup of tea. Her mother would prepare a cup of tea and she would tell Kezia to go and deliver it to the father. Okay. And when she enters, he must be sitting in the drawing room with his one leg onto the table, sitting on the sofa. And then what happens? What she used to do? She was often asked by the father for his shoes to be removed. And he would say that you are a good girl, how you behave throughout the day. Have you been a good girl throughout the day? And this is how, you can say, routine is carried forward. But the grandmother in the family, she was very much aware of this fact that Kezia is very afraid of her father. She's not sharing any good relationship with her father. So she is always trying each and every best way to make the girl, you can say, understand her parents, and the parents to develop a cordial as well as affectionate relationship with Kezia. So on Sundays, the grandmother usually asks Kezia to go and spend some time with the father. And how father is resting on that day? He's sitting and he's lying on the sofa in the drawing room with his, you can say, leg onto one of the best cushions of the house, and with handkerchief, or with his face covered with handkerchief. Okay. And the mother, what she's doing? Mother, she used to read newspapers. It means mother is also busy in her household work and her own, you can say, activities. So what this chapter is delivering, it is delivering the, you can say, the kind of relationship or kind of attention the children demands. Okay, that the children, they also have their own requirements, and it is the the duty of the parents to provide an affectionate as well as an understanding environment to all. Okay, so it is because of this reason what has happened that when her father, he is sitting with his, you can say, face covered with the handkerchief. And when her father would wake up, she would sit on the side, on the side table, and she would wait for her father to wake up. And until and unless her father would wake up, he will give a very, you can say, insulting remark. Why are you looking like an owl to me? Okay, you, Kezia, you seem to be on the verge of dying or on the verge of suicide. So these kind of remarks, they again and again, they were suppressing the love of Kezia. She's never thinking, she's never feeling that her father is her own father, okay? Moreover, she's so afraid of her father that she's often stuttering in front of her father. Otherwise, whenever somebody else is there in the home, she's never stuttering. She's not showing this kind of problem. but with her father she is often showing this problem, and it is because of this reason that she is not able to disclose her feelings to her father also, right? So later on what happened, it was the birthday of her father, and her grandmother, who is trying each and every way to make the girl well acquainted to her parents, she told Kezia that it's your father's birthday, you can present a beautiful cushion to your father. But she was not finding appropriate cloth in the entire house that was to be given as a gift. So finally she found a piece of yellow silk. Okay, she stitched all the three sides of the cushion, okay, meticulously, and but she did not find anything what to fill in. She looked into the house, she looked into each and every corner of the house, she also went to the mother's room also, but she did not find anything how to fill this cushion with. So finally what she has come out with, she went into the bedroom, and there what she has found that some of the, you can say, some of the papers, some of the sheets, at that time she was not knowing that they were important papers, okay. She found that some of the sheets were lying on the table, okay, they were lying on the table, and ultimately what has happened, she thought that they were spare papers, okay, useless papers. She tore those papers into small pieces and she stuffed the cushion with those papers, and finally what has happened, she was ready with her birthday present. It was an attempt to develop or to extend a, you can say, to extend a hand of healthy relationship with her, with her father. So later on what has happened, yes, in the evening the father came house, there was quite hustle and bustle in the house. He was asking, he was inquiring from each and every person in the house that if anybody has seen the papers. All the, you can say, all the servants in the house, they have been questioned, and moreover after that the mother was also asked. But what has happened, when it was nowhere to be found, Kezia was asked if she has seen any, you can say, sheets of paper in the room. Then she told mother that she has used those papers and she has filled the cushion with those papers. Actually what were those papers, those were very important papers which contained the speech of the father for court authority. What does this contain? It contains speech for court authority, okay. So finally the same thing was conveyed to the father. Father was red with anger, and finally he spanked the girl and has beaten her with stick also on her little palms, okay, little red palms. Then she was too afraid, she was sobbing, she was crying, and she was so helpless. But only the grandmother, she knew her pain. She took the little girl into her lap, sat in the rocking chair, and ultimately she wrapped her in the towel and made her sleep. But she asked her grandmother why God has made fathers for. So in her thoughts only, Kezia was thinking of the fathers, the different kind of fathers there are. So what she thought that there are different kind of fathers. At that time, she has remembered Mr. McDonald. Okay, Mr. McDonald. Okay, so who was the neighbor? Okay, he would see, the other day she had seen that Mr. McDonald was playing with the children, with the younger girl tucking the pockets of the coat and one sitting over his shoulder, and he was moving round and round. Okay, so through the fence she has seen, so over the fence she has seen, and ultimately she has recognized that there are different kinds of fathers actually. Okay, that there are different kinds of fathers, and her father is of strict nature, and he is very much different from Mr. McDonald. Okay, but the things never remain as same. There are, you can say, transitions from one phase to another. And there, of course, occurred a transition in their relationship also between Kezia and her father. So how this transition has taken place? So it has taken place when one day her mother fall ill. She was hospitalized. Grandmother has gone along with her mother to the hospital, and Kezia was all alone in the house. So there was also a cook in the house. Okay, so she tried, what was the name of the cook? Alice. Yes, Alice. She tried to make Kezia to sleep, but Kezia was not able to sleep because she is often having a nightmare. In this nightmare, what she is looking, she is looking that a butcher is coming towards her with a knife and a rope, and ultimately what this butcher is actually representation of her father. She's thinking that this butcher is just like her father, because she says that when her father yawns, he opens up his big mouth. Okay, so finally what happened again on that day, she had the same nightmare. She was again feeling the same same kind of fear, and often when she had this nightmare, she would scream and wake up from her sleep. So she again woke up from her sleep. Then what happened? Her father has come towards her help. He has come, he has, you can say, lighted the candle and ultimately took the younger girl in her hands and has taken her into his room. There on the bed were lying the newspapers. He has put the newspapers aside and made the girl to sleep there. He was by the side of the girl, and the girl snuggled her head under the shoulder or under the arm of her father. So this, at this moment, Kezia has felt the beating of the heart of her father. It is for the first time that she has felt that her father, who seems to be very tough and hard from outside, okay, but actually he is very soft from inside. He of course had feelings. He's too busy in earning the livelihood, in doing the other work of the house, that he's not getting any time he doesn't get any time to spend with his children. And it is because of this reason, this part is always missing in their lives. Also, for the first time, Kezia felt the softness in her heart, in his heart also. And she felt that her father is also a human being who has the same feelings like that of, you can say, other fathers. So it is for the first time she has come to know. And after that, what has happened? She has developed affectionate relationship with her father. Okay, so this is the chapter, The Little Girl. If I will ask you some of the questions, you will answer me side by side. Okay. What is the daily routine of the father before going to office? And would leave. Okay. So what kind of relationship is shared between Kezia and her father? Okay. It was a feeling of fear that has been shared between Kezia and her father. But only Kezia was afraid of her father. Okay. So if I will ask you, give the character sketch of Kezia's father. So what kind of man he was? Busy man, office going, hard going. Next, tired after coming. It means that he has a lot of work in the office. Then afterwards, strict father, soft from inside, never displays his feelings. Okay, how, why? Because he has great feelings for Kezia, but every time Kezia is afraid of her father. Okay. And what kind of girl Kezia was? What kind of girl Kezia was? Scared, okay, timid, weak she was. Used to stutter in front of her father, because whenever her father is coming, she's always stuttering in front of her father. Okay, then afterwards, creative she is also, okay, because she has made the pin cushion, okay, right? And of course, she's a child, so that, kind and soft-hearted, okay? So Kezia is of that sort, right? What present was made by Kezia for her father? From yellow silk. Okay, she has made a pincushion from the yellow silk, okay. What she has filled this cushion with? Some important documents from the port authority. Okay. Then afterwards, what efforts were made by grandmother to develop a good relationship between Kezia and her father? Right. And moreover, she has also told to make a pin cushion for her father on her birthday. Okay. Who was Mr. McDonald?
Their
neighbor he was. So was he strict with his children? Then, okay. What kind of relationship he was sharing with his children? What kind of relationship? Love, care, and affection. Okay, he was sharing with that of his children. Why was Kezia spanked? To fill the pin cushion. She has used those documents. And Kezia has done it intentionally? Or deliberately? No. She has not used those papers deliberately. It means that it was... Okay, fine. How did the father behave when she found Kezia all alone in the house? She snuggled her head under her arm. Okay, and then what was the nightmare that Kezia suffers from? Okay, scary mouth. Okay, so this is clear. Next poem is there in the next one, Rain on the Roof. Okay, let us do, after that we will do Truly Beautiful Mind. Okay, so next we are going to revise the poem. Who is the poet of the poem? Kurt Skinner. On the Roof by, see, so Kurt Skinner, the poet of this poem. So what the poet he has delivered through this poem? What he is delivering through this poem? What he is telling? Speak again.
A child's love for her mother, that she, even if she broke, they would always be remembered. She would always be remembered.
Okay, of course, this is one thing that the poet wants to deliver, but the main thing is soothness that is provided by nature. Here, what is nature? Nature is represented here in the form of rain. That when the rain falls onto the earth, it is acting as a tonic, it is acting as a, you can say, elixir, and it is acting as a, you can say, soothing ingredient for all forms of life. Because this not only refreshes the earth, this not only soothes the earth, but what it does also, it will also, it will also, yes, it is of course a blissful moment. Okay, because this is the time when a person comes out of the you can say busy schedule. Okay, otherwise the person is not getting any time in his busy routine to come in contact with oneself. Okay, because he's so busy in his other works that he's not getting time to rethink again what has happened in the past time or what has happened in the past life. Okay, so this is the time the poet, when he presses his head against the pillow in the cottage, he is feeling much relaxed because number of old memories, they have also come into his mind, and it is because of this reason that he was remembering all those memories who were coming into his mind. And out of those memories, one of the great memory, one of the most blissful memory is that of his mother. okay, he, which is no longer present at that moment. It means that she is dead. Okay, so he is feeling that her mother is of course you can say a figure of love, okay, who has shown her love every time whenever she pays a glance or she delivers a glance or she delivers a glimpse towards her children, right? So the poet is feeling a feeling of immense or deep, you can say, satisfaction, okay, when he presses his head against the pillow, okay, when he presses his head against the pillow, when he hears the sound of the rain on the shingles of the roof. What is shingles? Means tiled roof, okay, tiled roof of the cottage. So let us see the explanation of the poem. When the humid shadows means they cover the sky, they move. Humid showers means moisture laden clouds, okay, they cover the sky, one over all the starry spheres. Over all the starry spheres means all the shiny bodies in the sky, including the stars and the moon, okay, celestial bodies, and the melancholy darkness. Melancholy darkness is an example of transferred epithet also. Moreover, this is also an example of personification. No, it is a metaphor, not personification. Okay, it's a metaphor. And the melancholy darkness, okay, gently weeps in rainy tears. And this kind of melancholy darkness, melancholy means sadness, darkness which is filled with sadness, it has covered the entire area, it has covered the entire atmosphere, okay, so it gently weeps in rainy tears. So this melancholy sadness, it is wiped down, it is poured down from the face of earth in the form of tears, which is actually the rain, okay, which is the soft falling shower from the sky, okay. It means that rain wipes out all the sadness that is covering otherwise the sky or the atmosphere of the earth. It means the poet is also reflecting darkness as well as the atmosphere which is covered with clouds. It's not a happy one. He says that it is filled with sadness as no activity is going on at that time. So this is the reason why he is saying that it is filled with sadness. Okay. So, and what a bliss is to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed. And it is of course a blissful moment to press one's head against the pillow of the cottage and to lie there without any activity. And it is really a very, you can say, feeling of contentment, as well as a contending moment to have your head pressed against the pillow of a cottage and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. And what is there? And to just listen. And what to do? Just to listen to the pitter-patter sound of the rain. Pitter-patter sound is an example of onomatopoeia. Okay? Because pitter-patter, it refers to rain. Okay? So it is, of course, a blissful moment to just listen to the pitter-patter sound of the rain. Right? So next, every tinkle on the shingles has an echo in the heart. Every tinkle means every raindrop that falls onto the shingles. Shingles mean tiled roof of the cottage has an echo in the heart. It produces an echo in his heart. How it produces an echo in his heart? Yes, it brings an echo of the old memories that he was remembering at that time, okay, and a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start. Thousand dreamy fancies, again, this is in an example of what? This is an example of transferred epithet. And a thousand dreamy fancies, number of dreamy fancies, they also come into being, okay, they also come into being and blow, sorry, and into busy being start. Busy being is an example of alliteration. Moreover, this is again an example of transferred epithet. That number of dreamy fancies, they used to come into his mind and making his mind, which is otherwise free, filled with memories, making his mind busy. Okay, he turns out to be busy with the memories of past time. Okay, and a thousand recollections. and a thousand recollections mean thousand old memories. Thousand old memories also come into his mind and weave their air threads into woof. Weave their air threads into woof means weave air threads means that the air threads they join to form a fabric. It means that old memories, okay, some strands of old memories, they will join to formulate a particular incident that he remembers at that time. Okay, so this is the you can say these are the memories that he remembers at that time, and ultimately this makes him remind of the past events of life, right? And when this happens, the poet is saying, this happens when I listen to the pitter patter of the rain upon the roof. When this happens, when he listens to the pitter patter sound of the rain that falls. Okay, so let me ask you all the literary devices used here. Humid showers is an example of metaphor because this is a comparison made to that of clouds. Okay, then afterwards, melancholy darkness. This is a transferred epithet and metaphor. Starry spheres, metaphor, alliteration also. Okay, and pitter patter, onomatopoeia. Okay, this is an example of onomatopoeia. But here only patter is there, so onomatopoeia. Press the pillow, yes, it is alliteration. Cottage chamber is also alliteration. Next is dreamy fancies, busy being start, transferred epithet, and of course this is again an example of alliteration. Okay, and weave their air threads into woof, yes, this is an example of personification, and again patter is onomatopoeia. Okay, so the last paragraph we will continue in the next lecture. Okay, as we are running short of time, so the next one we will continue with this and the next chapter. Okay, so that's all for today. Now if you people have any doubt, you can ask me.